So you wanted to display your Minecraft stats like a pro? You stumbled upon the perfect video. Today I'm going to walk you through installing and customizing my boss bar configuration. Let's dive in. Alright, to make this magic happen, we're going to need a few trusty plugins. First up, grab TAB. It's our boss bar displayer extraordinaire. Next we'll snag Placeholder API, which lets us cram all sorts of cool stats into our bar. Oh, and by the way, I've linked all these lifesavers in the document provided in the description. No frantic searching necessary. And if you're like me and you want to pretend you're a high-rolling tycoon in Minecraft, because let's be honest, real-life riches are overrated, you can download Vault, Essentials X, and LPC. Together, they'll create an economy system so robust, you'll be swimming in virtual emeralds. Time to get our hands dirty. Let's drag all these fantastic plugins into our plugins folder, and hit that glorious restart button. Think of it as giving your server a fresh cup of coffee. I think I had too much coffee this morning. Phew, my least favorite part, installing plugins, is finally done. Now, in the document I provided, you'll find a basic boss bar configuration. So let's scroll down to the example config.yml and copy that beautiful block of text. Also, to display the custom icons on the boss bar, you'll need to download and apply the resource pack. Next, we'll head over to our server panel, navigate into the plugins folder, and then into the tab folder. Inside, you'll find a very important file called config.yml. Let's crack it open. We're on a treasure hunt for bars. Once you've unearthed it, go ahead and replace the entire bars section with what you copied. Don't forget to save your changes. Wouldn't it just be peachy if this plugin reloaded itself every time you saved a file? Unfortunately, we live in a cruel, unyielding world, so we have to do it ourselves. In-game, let's unleash this mighty command, tab reload. And just like that, you should be greeted by the default configuration. However, you might notice some of these pesky placeholders aren't quite formatted. Time to fix that. Alright, buckle up my fellow developers, because this is the trickiest part. I'll do my absolute best to make it sound less like rocket science. Placeholder is one of these mystical things, always starting and ending with these fancy percent symbols. The very first word of the placeholder is like a secret code. It tells you which extension you need to install. Think of an extension as a whole collection of placeholders. To make these placeholders actually work, we need to install the correct extension. To do this, we'll type the command /placeholderAPI ecloud download, followed by the extension name. So, for the first placeholder on our boss bar, the first word is server, which means we need to download the server extension. Now we'll apply this same brilliant logic to the others, which means we'll run /placeholderAPI download vault and /placeholderAPI download player. After we've done our downloading shenanigans, we need to type /placeholderAPI reload to see all those placeholders magically formatted. If you followed my instructions perfectly, and I know you did because you're awesome, you should see all your placeholders looking very fresh. Well done. That was exhausting for me just to explain. And just like that, you've got a cool looking boss bar that'll make all your friends jealous. If this video somehow manages to wrangle 100 likes, I'll create an epic tutorial on customizing this configuration. But don't let that stop you. Feel free to dive in and customize yourself. That's all for today's video. Thanks for watching. If this was helpful, do me a solid and click a few buttons so this can help even more people. See you in the next video.